Chesnara CEO John Deane joins us now here at Proactive London to talk to us about your half-year results. John, they're out. Talk me through the numbers.
Yeah, quite a steady half year, to be honest, and we're quite pleased with it. Our economic value increased $645 million, big IFRS profits $66 million, and dividend up 3% on the back of that for the 15th year in a run. So we're not unhappy about those in a market that is obviously nervous around everything that's going on. In terms of we just steadily deliver our results.
We'll talk about Brexit in just a moment, but if we can just draw back slightly and look at the broader picture as far as Chesnara is concerned. You're split into divisions, aren't you? Remind investors what they look like.
Well, about each of our divisions, three of them, one in Sweden, one in the Netherlands, one in the UK, and they each represent about a third of the value of the organisation. If we then go look at them individually, we're closed to new business in the UK. We're primarily a run-off book, and that's the major cash generator. And that's done very well this year, delivering good cash underlying the business. Sweden is, we're open to new business, and we've seen significant growth in funds, around about a 15% increase over the period. So very pleasing to see that. We've seen new business fall very slightly in value, but that's really a reaction to the back end of last year. Funds in terms of went down in the global market, people got a little bit nervous, but we're seeing customers return to us, and the second quarter was particularly pleasing in that respect. Netherlands, we have two businesses. We have Vard, which is a closed block, and that's continued to generate in terms of good cash. And Skilled, in our new business, we've nearly doubled the value of new business in the half year compared to the previous half year. We see an opportunity to do that. We've got a cost reduction program in Skilden that's beginning to deliver value for us in terms of our shareholders. So we're pleased with what the team has done there. So all in all, lots of good small things happening around the businesses altogether in terms of that's delivering good results to us. Reasonable cash. We've used some of that cash as a result of some technical thing called symmetric adjustment, which people can read about in our accounts if you can't sleep. But that's the sort of thing at the end of the day that people know us for, good cash generation, and we've certainly delivered again this year.
And just returning to the Brexit question and indeed the impact or not thereof, You mentioned that two divisions of your company are based both in Sweden and in the Netherlands. Obviously that's krona and euro, so not European based rather than euro based. But what impact, if any, would Brexit have on your business?
Well, we're structured, each business that was in the territory stands alone in terms of is fully regulated and reports to the local regulator. So we don't cross-sell across borders, we haven't got any passporting, we haven't got people who've got to move from one territory to another. So pretty much no impact at that level. Where we do see potential for impact is if interest rates fall, which is looking more likely, in terms of that will have a little bit of an impact on the business. If sterling falls, clearly with two-thirds of our business in Europe, then from a currency point of view, we'd expect to see positive gains in the half year as a result of that. So we think we're well positioned for shareholders who are concerned about what the impact of Brexit might be. And after 15 years of increasing dividends, we think in terms of we can deliver for them in the future.
Let's talk about your price. It is up a little bit, although it has drifted. What do you think the reasons are for that?
Well, I think we're actually not seeing an awful lot of selling of the share in terms of it is that partly that August syndrome. But I think we've also seen what I might call the Woodford effect in terms of people get a little bit concerned around income funds and can they get their money out, etc. Those are factors that are external to us. All we can do is deliver in terms of the value. And we think at the representing our own funds, you're like one measure of value of the company, it's about £3.90 a share. If you look at it as economic value, it's about £4.30. If we deliver that, we'll let the market judge about what the right price is for us. We've seen some drifting, but we hope that in terms of we are temporary in terms of process, and that people will get back to valuing Chesnara in the way they have previously done so.
So for the investor that's watching you for the very first time, who's perhaps looking into what Chesnara is doing and is noting that slight price rise, In a nutshell, why should they take a position, do you think?
I think in terms of because we do what says on the tin. Chesnara, in terms of is an anagram, if you go away and sort of play it out in terms of see what it says earn cash. That's what we do, and that cash provides dividend.
I see what you did there.
Yeah. Okay.
Great to talk to you. John Deane, thanks very much indeed.
Okay, thank you.